you know what an eyeshadow primer is?
Yes, it's there to set your eyeshadow.
Okay, so basically, what does that mean? Set your eyeshadow.
So that your eyeshadow can last.
Correct. Okay, so guys, an eyeshadow primer, if you have oily eyelids like myself, it's a good idea to prime your eyelids before you do eyeshadow. Okay, this one is from Essence. It just says 2-in-1 eyeshadow and primer, long lasting brightening and flawless finish. Okay, so this is what it looks like. That's the lid. And inside, so you get eyeshadow primers of different colors, right? I'm just gonna apply it with my fingers across my entire lid like that. Not sure what the price of this is, but Essence products are very well priced. So it's just giving me a nice base on my lid. You can also just apply foundation onto your eyelids and use that as a primer or concealer. However, if you have very oily eyelids like mine, foundation and concealer won't work at prolonging the life of your eyeshadow. Okay, then in that case, you need an actual eyeshadow primer. So,
I have normal eyelids, so I can just use eyeshadow.
You can go straight over foundation or concealer. Okay. Yeah. So we're going to use this palette from NYX. It's called Swear By It. Just because it's got a really nice
brush.
Yes, the brush is from the Metallic Pearl collection. We've got two fluffy brushes, which we're going to use in the crease. We've got a more flat brush. This one is flat for the lid, or you can use your fingers for the lid. And we've got a small one for the dark shade. Okay, so what do you understand about smoky eyes?
It must be darkier and lighter.
Yes, so it's going to go from dark into light. And what color is a smoky eye?
Brown.
Brown, which other colors?
Black.
Black. So it can be any colors, right? So smoky eye can be brown smoky, black smoky, green smoky, purple smoky. It can be done with one eyeshadow color, with two, with three, with five, with 10. It can be a brown and gold smoky. It can be, so guys, remember, smoky eye doesn't mean that it's just black. Okay. It's just going from a dark into a light. Okay, so what we're gonna do first, we're gonna take our fluffy brush and we're gonna use a warm brown in the crease. So maybe something like this.
I thought I must use the color that looks like my skin first.
Why? No. You're just going to use... So, whenever you're doing eyeshadow blending, you want to have one transition color, one color in the crease. But it must be like a nice warm brown. And for every single smoky eye, you can start with that color. But you'll see now. So, we can both use... We can either use this one or we can use this one. Okay, so maybe let's use the darker one just for the sake of YouTube. I'm swirling my brush in here. Gonna tap off the excess. Remember, don't blow into your brush because you don't want to put spit and bacteria into your brush, especially if you're working on other people. Okay, then we're gonna go. So for beginners, it's also a good idea to look down into a mirror while you're blending. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna go with our fluffy brush and we're gonna blend into the crease, and then you do the crease. Okay.
Yeah.
Okay, so guys, this is my fluffy blending brush. This is my eyeshadow color. Tap off the excess. Now I'm going to place the brush here on the side and I'm going to go like this into the crease in windscreen wiper motions like this. Left, right, left, right, left, right, left, right, like that. About 100 times. Okay. You can also do these circular movements like that. So I just want to point out for you quickly, this is a fluffy blending brush. If you had to use a flat brush, you wouldn't be able to do that motion, am I right?
Yes.
So it's the right brush, yeah. So, do you want to look down into the camera?
No, I'm professional.
Oh, sorry, into the mirror. Okay, she's looking, there we go. Left, right, into the crease. Okay, so just show them what you've done there. Beautiful. Okay, so let's go to the other one. Tap off the excess. So she knows the step already, you can see. Because I'll tell you why, she hasn't gone too high with the crease color. She's used to blending in the crease. Okay, so as beginners, just remember, You want to go into the crease over here. You don't want to take your medium color right up to there. Okay. And what you can do is you can blend. So first,
you have nice big eyelids to play with.
So first, what you're doing is you're actually spreading, you're applying the product and you're spreading it. And then after a while, you're blending it out. Right? So that's why you're going in over and over again. Can I just say, by the way, guys, if you are using a poor quality eyeshadow, you're going to have to do that over and over again in order to see it. So this is a very good quality eyeshadow palette from NYX. You saw Chic and I swiped once and you could already see the eyeshadow on your skin, right? So if you're using a poor quality eyeshadow, you won't be able to see it properly. So also just make sure that you're using the right products. Remember I did mention the fluffy blending brush. Okay, so that is your transition color. Do you understand what a transition color is? It's the medium color that's taking you from your light color into your dark color. It's the medium color, okay? So for your transition color, you always want a warm shade, and a warm brown is gonna be perfect, always, no matter what. If it's a green smoky, purple smoky, blue smoky, gold, you wanna always start with a peachy, orangey, warmish brown in your crease, okay? You'll see if you go into all of your other, looks that makeup artist created for you, there's always a warm color in the crease. Okay, so now what we're gonna do, we're gonna put a shimmer on the lid. So I think we should go.
Are we done with smoking it out now?
No, we're gonna come back to it later. Okay. I just wanna go to the next color, which is the lid color. Okay. So we're gonna put on this one. The reason why I chose such a light shimmery color is because I wanted to choose three colors that are very contrasting so that they can see the difference between the light, the medium, and the dark color, especially for the sake of YouTube. So this is the shimmer. Do you understand the difference between shimmer eyeshadows and matte eyeshadows? So shimmer obviously is glowing, right?
Glittery.
And then the matte color is flat. There's no shimmer. Mm. So we're going to use a shimmer on the lid, which you can do with your finger like this, and then just swipe it like this across your lid. So for your lid color, if it is a shimmer, you can apply it with your fingers. It's a very good way to apply the lid shade. The reason is because the shimmer attaches to your finger really well and applies to your lid very well. It basically holds the product really well. Okay, so that color, the placement is all over your lid, right up to meet the crease color. We're gonna go into the fluffy brush again, and we're going to blend where these two colors meet. So I'm not even taking more product. I'm using the product that's left over on the fluffy brush. I'm just going like that. Remember, because we're using such a good quality product, we can just use what's left on the fluffy brush. And we're blending back into the crease. So here you can see that wherever the lid color is meeting the crease color, we've blended in the middle. Okay, let's see. Close. Okay, so when you are doing your eyeshadow blending, just make sure that you have symmetry on both eyes. So you can actually add a little bit more. Close me. Show you.
Oh, I thought so. It's more on the side.
A bit higher. Yeah. But that's why, guys, another tip from me. When you're doing your own makeup, you can also take some selfies of your makeup with your eyes closed. Check the selfie and see that you have the same colors that you have symmetry. Let me do the other side. Close. And we're going to go in with a dark shade. Okay, this is still from the Metallic Fill collection. And we're just going to use a dark brown, something like that. So this was our warm brown. Where was it? That was our crease color. I'm going to go something darker like that. So we're doing like a sort of like a brown smoky with a shimmery lid, or like a neutral lid. Okay, so here's my pencil brush. So the darker the color, the smaller the brush. Okay, so I'm going to go in and I'm just going to place it here in the corner. And this is what we call a V. You'll be able to see now it's going in like a sideways V like that. Right? So do that for me. Tap off the excess. And just on the corner of your actual lid. Just over there. Yeah. Nice. Okay. Make it pointy on the edge so it looks like a V. Okay. And now we're gonna go back to that fluffy brush and we're gonna do this and we're just gonna blend it in this corner. So what beginners tend to do wrong is they tend to take this brown, this dark shade right over. But you just want to blend it in that corner.
Mm.
So it's going from dark into light. Just over there. Yeah, nice. Just in that corner. Remember, don't take it too far over your lid. Okay. So now you can do the other eye. Okay. We're just creating a V on the side. Like that. And you want to also just make sure that you have the same amount of dark. You can look down into the mirror.
Oh, that you can see I'm not used to doing.
Okay, and you just blend over the... So, you want to do this? Yeah, perfect. Right? So, we are not done yet. The reason why is what the professional does is the professional actually goes back into all three colors. So, we'll go back into the medium, back into the light, back into the dark. Okay, but all we've done is we've actually only used two brushes. We've used a fluffy brush and a pencil brush. The light color, we used our finger. Okay? So, what we're going to do, we can go back into the lid color. And just go over it again. But now that your dark is here, look here, just gonna make sure you're just going over your lid color just in the corner to pop it a bit. You're not gonna go over the dark. Okay. Yeah. And you can go a little bit higher. See? Really nice. Beautiful. Okay, so now we've reapplied the lid shade. We can just go over the medium shade. Okay, and don't worry about anything, any fallout, because that we can just clean with foundation or makeup wipes underneath.
So we're done now.
So basically what I just want to say is that is a basic smoky eye. It's got a light color, a medium color, and a dark color. Do you understand the placement? We put the medium color in the crease, put the light color on the lid, and put the dark color in the V on the side. Yeah, there's no solid lines in the application. Okay. So remember guys, you have to have clean makeup brushes for this. You can't use last week's green eyeshadow. And now, okay, so here's your clean brush. Just blend out the solid lines for me. Just on the edge, yeah. So on that edge there. There we go, perfect. And for any eyeshadow that has dropped, we can take your foundation. So this is the leftover foundation on a concealer brush. So we're just going to clean like this. Let me just show it in. So you'll see a lot of people use Sellotape there. They add some Sellotape so when they're blending, then it goes into this triangle. But you could also just take whatever's left over on your foundation brush or your concealer brush, just cut it upwards, and you're kind of like cleaning your... Just blend that for me. Cleaning your eyeshadow. Okay, let me show you how I'm doing it. Leftover foundation or concealer. Okay. So now you can see your eyeshadow is blending upwards into like towards like a wing. And what does it do if your eyeshadow is in the shape of a wing? What does it do to your face?
If the eyeshadow is in the shape of a wing.
Like it's going like this.
It does something to my eyes.
It lifts your eyes.
Oh,
right?
Okay.
It lifts your face. Can I go for it? Okay, so guys, remember I mentioned to you that...
Sorry, can I just say I can't touch my nose anymore because I touched my nose in the first video and someone commented.
Oh,
she's
yes.
She's so unprofessional touching it.
Yeah.
Anyway, yeah.
Okay, clearly that girl hasn't been on video camera because it's very nerve-wracking. Okay, so guys, The tip that I wanted to give you, remember I mentioned earlier to you that it's gonna, if you are serious about your eyeshadow blending, it's gonna be a good idea for you to invest in a very good eyeshadow palette. So you don't have to go and spend hundreds of rands. NYX has some very good eyeshadow palettes. You can get it from the NYX store. I think it's closing, but you can get from Clicks and Dis-Chem, right?
They're still there. You have to take them as well.
Yeah. But you can also try one of the other drugstore brands, Essence. Apparently, Makeup Revolution has really good eyeshadow palettes. But your eyeshadow must be pigmented, right? If you want to, if you're serious about your eyeshadow blending. Then the other thing is, you do need...
Your thing looks perfect, your blending, your
eye. Thank you. It needs to be because I'm a pro. If it wasn't, we would be in trouble. The other thing is, you need good brushes, right? You need a nice fluffy brush for your crease. And if you have very, very small eyes, the smaller the brush would be better. But I mean, this one is fine from the metallic pools. It should go in to all eye shapes, right? Then a good idea is to have a very small brush, like the pencil brush, for the dark shade. Why? Imagine I had to use a big brush for the dark shade. The dark shade would be all over the place. Okay. The other tip I want to give you as a beginner is, it's a good idea to start your eyeshadow blending first and then clean up the fallout and then move to skin. If you're going to go straight to skin and then you do eyeshadow, you may have fallout underneath of the eyeshadow and then you have to go and you have to clean and you're going to waste time. Okay, so if you're going to do especially a dark smoky, I'd first go to eyeshadow blending, do my dark smoky, then I would clean underneath, then I would go to my skin. Okay.
Stunning. Thank you so much, Rosanna. That was the end of our smoky eye. Next week, we'll do another eye look.
Yeah, so going forward, I want to do, we're going to recreate a few looks from start to finish.
Okay, cool. Yeah. Now we should do brow also, maybe sometime.
Yeah, but my brow and your brow is almost perfect. We need someone else to teach on brows.
Okay. Just be here next week, guys. We are going to give you another fire class.
Yeah, we've got these loads of classes. We can do color theory. We can do.
Maybe you can let us know what you want to see as well.
We can do red carpet looks. Oh, we can also do wing liner.
Yeah,
and we will also do. We will feature Rosby lashes.
Yeah, soon, because they want to see how I apply lashes. But yeah, comment what you want to see, what you'd like to see. I can't promise that I'll give it to you in the next video, but at least we know what you're looking for. Yeah, thank you for tuning in. We love you.
Thank you. Bye.
Ciao.